In what could be one of the biggest frauds in the history of Indian banking, Punjab National Bank has reported unauthorized transactions worth 11,400 crores in one of its branches in South Mumbai. The Enforcement Directorate has registered a money laundering case in the matter, which involves Mumbai-based billionaire diamond merchant Nirav Modi, or NiMo as he's being called. The Deputy General Manager of Punjab National Bank's Zonal Office, Anvish Nepalia, filed a complaint on the issue with the CBI. Nepalia alleged that Nirav Modi, Nishal Modi, Ami Modi and Mehul Choksi, all of whom are partners at Diamond R Us, Solar Exports and Stellar Diamonds, conspired with a retired bank employee and a current staffer to defraud the bank. The bank has alleged that the accused employees issued 293 letters of undertaking and 224 foreign letters of credit since 2011 in favor of NiMo's companies to the Hong Kong branches of Allahabad and Axis Bank. The companies connected to Nirav Modi got letters of undertaking through fraud from PNB. As per these LOUs, PNB assured overseas branches of other Indian banks like the Allahabad Bank that it would stand guarantee to the loans given by these banks to Nirav Modi. According to banking rules, any such guarantee should have been backed up by a collateral from the borrower. But in this case, NiMo has obtained LOUs without putting any collateral, with collusions with some of the bank officials. Instructions by Society for Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunication, or SWIFT, were transmitted to the overseas branches of other Indian banks to loan out money to Nirav Modi's companies without making any entry in the account books. PNB claims that the scam began in 2011 and the amount has gone up to ₹11,400 crores, which is about 8.5 times its annual profit last year. That's 1/3 of its market capitalization before the scam came out. It is also more than double the amount of money the government put into PNB this year to recapitalize the bank. PNB claims that the fraud went undetected since 2011 because the LOUs sent through SWIFT were not tallied with company's core banking system, and so the management never came to know these went out in the first place. But how did this happen? For 7 years, all the audits and checks have failed to detect this massive scam. The entire story seems too fishy to be credible. The Modi government was informed several times that fraud was being carried out by Nirav Modi and others, but the government turned a blind eye. Nirav Modi and others fled the country in early January, coolly attended the World Economic Forum at Davos, got photographed with Modi, and only afterwards, at the end of January, did the CBI and PNB start looking into their fraud. It seems like they allowed NiMo and friends to flee, just like Malia.
ये मेहुल चौकसी जो हैं, ये भी नीरव मोदी के पार्टनर हैं, जो गीतांजलि ज्वेल्स है, मेहुल चौकसी, वही नाम है ना उनका।
लेकिन बैंक से ज़्यादा उसको अपने गांव के सोनार पे भरोसा है। वो बड़े से बड़े ज्वेलरी के शोरूम में जाएगा, लाने के बाद अपने सोनार के यहाँ जरा चेक कर ले भाई, कितना ही बड़ा शोरूम होगा, हमारे मेहुल भाई यहाँ बैठे हैं, लेकिन वो जाएगा अपने सोनार के यहाँ, जरा भाई तुम चेक करो, मैं ले तो आया हूँ।